Thank you very much, sir, for your kind words of welcome. The topic I was asked to introduce today is, of course, extremely broad. So I decided to focus on something which I am currently working on behalf of the Interparliamentary Union. And I will focus mostly on the effectiveness of aid. Of course, the effectiveness of trade and the trade negotiations are something also very important. But today, I think there is a growing awareness that we have spent billions in official development aid, and that the situation of many countries in Africa, I don't speak of Asia and Latin America, where development has been for most countries a reality, but we have spent billions of euros or billions of dollars in Africa, and we have to notice today that except for a few exceptions, which you can count on the fingers of your hand, that the poverty is still extremely widespread and even growing in many, many African countries. So, and also today we have the awareness that most sub-Saharan countries will not be able to achieve in 2015 the Millennium Development Goals which have been set in 2000 by the United Nations Assembly General. These goals are not goals which are quantified in terms of GDP, but which are indexes of poverty reduction, such as mortality rates for children, literacy rates, life expectation, and so on and so on. So those Millennium Development Goals will, today we are aware of the fact that for most, practically all of the sub-Saharan countries, except for a few of them, most of those goals will not be achieved, notwithstanding the billions and billions of euros which we have collectively spent in Africa since the independence of those states, which means today since about 50, 55 years. So one has to raise the question of the effectiveness of aid. How can we develop mechanisms which will improve the effectiveness of the money we spend in several mostly African countries, although there are also still some critical cases in Asia and Latin America, but they are not very numerous, except maybe if we see the situation in Haiti, of course, this is one of the extreme cases we can imagine. But the reasons of the lack of effectiveness of the official development aid, whether bilateral or multilateral, in Haiti are more or less the same as for many African states. So, of course, today it is true that several countries have not yet fulfilled all the promises they have made as far as the amount of aid is concerned, promises they made in Monterrey in 2002. But stronger and stronger voices are coming up today saying that it is not only the amount, but maybe more and more the lack of effectiveness of foreign and foreign aid supporting countries which struggle to get rid of poverty, which is insufficient or ineffective. This inefficiency, as I will try and demonstrate today, is, in my opinion, intimately linked with a lack of effective democratic institutions in many of the beneficiary, or even in most of the beneficiary countries of foreign aid. Poor governance and deficit of democratic ownership of national strategies are two traits that tend to reinforce each other. Of course, one can give examples of countries which have been able to develop without democratic institutions. There are a few examples in the world. China, up to now. Some Gulf countries. Also Singapore. There are a few examples. But this morning, a German professor, I am checking for his name here, on the, Professor Enderlein, made a very real remark. He said, when the middle class will expand in China, they will also have to turn to more democratic system, to a more democratic system. And I think this is true. You can, during a short period of the history of a country, have a non-democratic regime developing because that country has some specific cultural heritages which make it possible to develop without having any democratic institutions. But I think those countries are the exception rather than the rule, and I don't think they can go on forever doing this. But so I do believe that in most of the countries which are today struggling without success to achieve the Millennium Development Goals, there is a real lack of democracy, which is the real explanation of why the aid we are giving and why there is